Paco y Brea, usted está en Cali. Ay, mire, vea. Si las mujeres son lindas y hermosas, aquí no hay fea, para que vea. Mi Cali se está adornando para su fiesta más popular, con caña dulce el melao, hierve en la paila hasta amanecer. Habrá corrida de toros y por la noche fiesta y rumba. En Cali, mira, se sabe gozar. En Cali, mira, se sabe gozar.
Quedan imperfecciones.
Fue
el primer ave que en la mitología trajo más importante para la cultura.
Cultivaba mucho coca.
Al pueblo de los Kogi.
O religiosa más importante de la cultura.
Yeah, the why is a very interesting question.
We believe that as individuals, when we come together as communities and decide what is truly important, to love each other, love ourselves, and love this planet, that magic happens. Our mission is to bring people to a beautiful place to experience it, but if you're not actually connecting with it and giving back to it, you're missing out on a huge piece of what it means to be a part of this world.
Yeah, so participants first, they come to Santa Marta, which is a awesome colonial Spanish town on the northern coast of Colombia. A lot of vibrant energy.
Getting some more context for Colombia as a country.
We start there, we get everything kind of prepared, make sure that everybody has what they need to go on the course.
How to pack a pack, how to make sure that we have all the proper necessary items that we will need on this trek.
That we're all ready to embark on this mission to really ultimately try to help change ourselves and our outlook on the world. So that takes a little bit of prep time to do that. And then we head into the jungle. So we first work with a company down there that's been doing these trips on to the lost city, Ciudad Perdida. So we go there and we trek into the jungle for 4 nights, 5 days. We go up to Ciudad Perdida, Teyuna is the name of the city.
Trek to the lost city is challenging, and that's one of the amazing things about it.
Very far and untouched in the jungle.
Like a significant amount of time just walking to get to that place.
Most other archaeological sites that you can go to in Central or South America, you can get to pretty easily. And this one still had a little bit of like an intact feeling, or a feeling of that you could imagine how it was working in the larger context of the nature that was surrounding it.
You end with like 1,200 feet of just stairs leading up. You like feel like you're walking into the heavens or like the clouds.
Going to this amazing terraced archaeological ruin that's thousands of years old in the middle of a super biodiverse jungle environment.
And the jungle just opened up all around us. The greenest green you've ever seen. The jungle is just so alive and provides so much. Like, I felt vibrations were very high being there. You were like, wow.
So it can be a little bit challenging in terms of miles that we hike, but it's totally doable by any age group, any person, as long as they have the willpower to do it. So that's our example of macro tourism. So we can see how things work on a larger context on the northern coast of Colombia, and then how we're trying to change some of that. So from there, we go to Quebrada del Sol, and we work directly with a community and directly with an indigenous population.
I think one of the most unique parts of the trip is an opportunity for us to go and experience intimately a completely different way of living
So spending time with the Kogi, the indigenous group that we work with, they are guardians of Mother Nature. They self-proclaim themselves as that. And they believe that the world that they live in, the mountain range, is the heart of the world.
The Kogi are praying for the world every day.
So going and spending time with people that just have that particular belief system and still operate in a way that is very in tune with nature. They bathe in the river, they wash their clothes in the river, they get all their clothing from the plants that they live around, they depend on the natural resources that they cultivate, and then they live in these natural buildings where it's very easy to make.
And meeting them, it's simplicity and just being in a place at its all-time beauty. They're literally just living their lives, which means living in community, creating food, living with the land in a place. I mean, that sounds so simple.
There's only a few people that end up going to this indigenous spot. So how do we like also visit them, but realize that they have a different way of living and we have a different way of living, and that we need to learn from both of our ways of living.
We're leaving a trace on their sacred land. Felt irresponsible that we were coming in and we were negatively affecting this beautiful land that they have been taking care of.
Indigenous community, there's maybe 50 people in total that end up going and spending time with them, and we're lucky enough to be one of those groups. But there's very little infrastructure. Say if we needed to go to the bathroom, there's very little places that, if there's a bigger influx of tourists that go to that area, there's going to be some contamination of the local resources in the area.
What we could do to not negatively affect their land was to create a composting toilet. This would also be a dry composting toilet that the waste could eventually be turned into compost that could be used in the gardens, in the cacao field, in their banana groves, that could all be given back to the earth. And so we would not be negatively influencing their land with our waste.
And this is a project that they think if they can recreate and rebuild, they can bring to other indigenous communities and slowly make a change towards a more sustainable or healthy human waste system that they don't have in place right now. So then from there, we kind of end our experience in La Sierra Nevada de Santa Marta, the mountain range, and we head towards the top of South America to get a better look at the Wayuu. El aguacero me tiene loco, no quiere caer. La luna ya no se mete. Spend a few days going north via car and 4x4 land cruisers to get to Punta Gallinas.
Vast spans of pure desert, secluded, beautiful beaches, sand dunes, exposed, very challenging environment to survive in.
Large swaths of desert that are inhabited by the Wayuu, this ancient group that was never conquered by the Spanish, and they were the first people to interact with the Spanish in South America, and they are the people of the dream world. So we learn from them by seeing the environment that they live in, this desert dry environment, but their biggest problem has always been water in that area. So the water issue is a larger political aspect that we just can't get too involved in, but what we can do is make smaller changes that have like lasting impacts for the people. So
the wells that they get their water from have been there for hundreds of years. They are currently owned specifically by individual families. The water out there is so precious that you will see concrete and chains across the top of individual wells so that only family members who actually own that well can collect this vital resource in the desert.
There is a need for water transportation and access of water. So while we enjoy the Caribbean and while we see these amazing turquoise seascapes, as well as these cactus islands that are in the middle of these desert seascapes, we end up doing projects up there too, service projects that help with the tourism that goes up there to make sure that we have available water access for many generations to come. Right now they get their water from their wells and that works for them, but they're using these huge plastic jugs and sometimes have to spend up to like half of the day going and collecting all the water that they need. So just with our introduction of some collapsible water jugs, that will change the game for them because they can carry a lot more at once and they can also make less trips overall during the day to get the same amount of water that they need to their houses, just to live, to bathe, to eat, to drink.
We got the unique opportunity to sleep in traditionally made Wayuu hammocks.
Sleep in these chinchorros, which are a local hammock that the Wayuu produce, these elaborate hammocks with multiple colors, and sleep next to the ocean in a dry desert environment. We go and we see the natural resources up there, all the beautiful birds that migrate through the area on their quest down to the bottom of South America, and also just the migratory birds that pass along the northern coast.
Physically stand at the northernmost part of Colombia. The wind, a force that I was not prepared for, the force of the wind in this area whips through the desert without any thought or reason.
It's another beautiful area where we get to enjoy and have a difference between what we just experienced for almost 2 weeks in La Sierra Nevada de Santa Marta jungle environment to a very desert environment where you still have one of the largest indigenous groups in Colombia living, but in a totally different resource.
The Wayuu will share an evening of cultural exchange.
And so their dances represent their tradition, and they all represent different animals, and they represent the connection between the man and the woman. They represent their thoughts and their dreams of how they receive water and where to find water. So all of their belief system revolves around their connection to the natural world and their messages that they receive from their dreams to help them find water and to help them find food
and tell us what their meanings are behind them, and also invite us to participate in indigenous dance.
The best thing that I could say is it's an opportunity for you to realize the power that you have with inside of you to make positive and beneficial change for the people around you. And we do that by these different aspects of learning from people that are already connected to Mother Nature and to the natural world. We learn it by the self-discovery as we challenge ourselves through walking and living in the natural world. And then we also challenge ourselves into action by doing projects of service so that we can actually get our hands into working with the change that we want to see.
You look at it completely different. You realize that it is our job and part of everyone's responsibility to be loving it. And loving the earth means taking care of it, giving back.
But also remembering that Mother Nature has a big role in teaching us who we are, what we really need in life. And so this trip is an example of regaining that connection so that you can go forwards with that in life and remember that there is places like this, there are people like this that have a connection to Mother Earth, and they protect it every day. Any job that we do, like, we should be working for the preservation of this land for 7-8 generations beyond us.
And part of the Guardian's mission is to invite people to come and start that call to give back to the earth. It's time for us to take care of Mother Earth.
Perfect.
We gotta reach out.
No.
Colombia llora, lloro también, lloro también. Colombia llora, lloro también para los niños que mueren. Bogotá llora, lloro también, lloro también. Bogotá llora, lloro también para los niños que mueren. Le gouvernement nous ment, nous ment comme il respire pour des histoires de fric, des putains de causes politiques. La drogue, la corruption et les textes marxistes. On le droit de vie et de mort sur les terres d'Amérique. Les narcoterroristes, paramilitaristes. Les riches dans votre pays et pour eux c'est pratique. Car l'Occident s'en fout et c'est là qu'est le hic. Ma vie ne vaut pas celle des enfants du G8. Colombia, llora, lloro también, lloro.